Matthew 5, Jesus starts talking. Now, a lot of the other Gospels have Matthew, or Jesus talking before this point in his ministry. But in Matthew, the first time Jesus starts talking, he's on a mountain. He's got a mass following. John the Baptist is in prison. And he starts expounding upon the law. The first thing he does, just starts to say, hey, it's written, thou shalt not commit murder. But I tell you the truth, if you don't settle your debts with your brother before you take him to court, you know, or if you have anger towards your brother in your heart, then you've already committed murder. He's kind of just expounding upon the law. Now, Jesus came to save us and set us free from the law, because the wages of sin are death, right? So he's trying to show us that we need him, because there's no way that we can, on our own will, fulfill these things, because the Pharisees had taken the law and boiled them down to more actionable items, and then added some things to the law that would make it easier for them and harder for the rest of the other people to actually be self-righteous or be considered righteous through their own works. And so Jesus is saying, no, just because you think that you've fulfilled the Ten Commandments, just because you haven't actually murdered somebody, you actually haven't cheated on your spouse, you haven't stolen property from your neighbor. Jesus is going through what we call concupiscence, and so concupiscence means you're thinking of doing these things, you're dreaming of these things, you're lusting after other people's wives. I talked to I'm an ice fisherman. I talk to Christian men and non-Christian men all the time who say, oh, it's okay to look just as long as you don't touch. No, that's not what Jesus is saying. Jesus is saying, no, you look, that's just as bad as adultery. You don't have to actually commit the act of adultery to be in trouble for the sin of adultery. So what he's doing is he's expounding upon the law, because you need to be pierced in the heart by the law to be able to do two things. One, live a sanctified life. Which, if he's talking to Christians, that's really what he's doing, is he's ordering their lives for them. But two, to need to know that there's a need for a Savior. If you think you can actually get to heaven through your own works and your own justification, then why Jesus? That's why most religions in the world don't have a Jesus that saves them from their sins. It's an order of works that gets you to heaven in some kind of way, or gets you reincarnated in a way that's better than how you currently have before. It's yourself focusing on yourself. There's a lot of things that you can do. The Bible doesn't have a whole lot of things you can do to get to heaven. There's actually nothing you can do to get to heaven, and that's why Jesus' ministry in Matthew starts with expounding upon the law, talk about the ways that we've broken the Ten Commandments. Just like in the Old Testament, you would hear God's condemnation for all these nations, and then right at the end of condemning these nations and promising that they would be destroyed, he would talk about the redemption and the Savior. So you always have that law piercing the heart before the gift of the gospel comes out, and that balance of law and gospel you see both in the Old Testament and the New Testament. Happy Tuesday. We'll talk to you tomorrow.